Hola, I'm Aiden. Today I'll be taking a quick little overview on a mod that I did about a week ago, I think. Might have been a little longer. But I never got around to posting it because I'm lazy. But this is the Adventure Force Enforcer. You know, it takes belts. It normally has a long barrel, and it has one of these on each side, one here, and then this little thing that holds the belt in a weird triangle position. But I don't like those. They just take up space. I also don't want to use belts anymore. That's why I did what I did. I completely removed the rotation mech, which is sitting over there, and I epoxied a Raider magwell to the side of it. This is not an original mod. Welcome S7 did this quite a while ago with a Scorpion. So this is basically the same thing with a newer version of the blaster. The mags fit really the mags go in really nicely. They're lined up nicely with the pusher. Now it has an on-off switch. There's a lot of Adventure Force blasters instead of a row switch, but. You can see the pusher is lined up pretty well with it. It is functional. Here it is with some Adventure Force darts. So you can see, not a super fast rate of fire. It is completely stock internally. It will get upgraded to LiPo eventually. But that might not happen until January, because a friend from War, the same friend who actually gave me the Enforcer, Terran, or Sir Brick, he gave me this and a bunch of blasters in a trade, and I figured I'd do something with it, so this is what I did. He's also going to wire it up, because I'm bad with that kind of stuff. I have a garbage soldering iron, I just don't really have the cash to buy a new one, plus I don't feel like it. But yeah, the battery tray, it takes 6 AA's. It actually fits a LiPo that I got for something else really well, so that's nice. All I have to do is carve out the battery tray and get rid of those stupid AA's. But yeah, I'm going to put these guys in it. This is a set of worker wheels. They're bigger than the normal wheels, like diameter wise, because they're high crush, but it is a fairly low crush cage, as you can see. It doesn't hurt to put my finger in it. The dart just kind of, it doesn't get crushed too much, so these wheels will give it a nicer crush. I dropped them there. They'll give it a nicer crush, so hopefully higher FPS. Probably gonna get Michel 2.0s in there because they're cheap, and then of course the LiPo. And then its stock wheels are very similar to size to a containment crew Cyclone. Yeah, I have a bunch of flywheels. These I got for practically free. My friend, same Terran, gave me these. And the shafts are completely melted. I have another one somewhere. I tried fixing them, but I don't think they're fixable. But these wheels are very similar to arguably the best wheels on the market right now. So I might try putting those in a Strife and see how that goes. A Strife? Me using a Strife? What? Yeah, I should have a Strife in December. But yeah. I'm excited to get that wired up. I'm also trying to decide, should I paint the thing, or should I leave it in its nice janky form, because I like that. Paint it up, give it a name. Yeah. What do you guys think? Comment down below, tell me, should I paint it, or should I leave it nice and janky? Fire off some more rounds. I might try to get a rev trigger for it eventually, because that's annoying like that. Yeah. Don't think there's much else I can say about it. Yeah, pretty much it. if you guys enjoyed this quick little motto review of my MagFed Enforcer. That's pretty much it. Adios! Also, if you haven't seen my last video, it was about this little RC tank, which is about my favorite thing in the world right now. Go watch that video. Alright, adios.